Hi, Geoff Lawton here. Well, we've had quite a lot of rain. From flood to drought, or drought to flood, here we are. I'm in the top swale. Let me show you, about to turn down the top swale pipe. Top of the property full, bottom's filling. I'm gonna let it go. I'll show you how it works. Here we are. I'm up to my knees in water. It's over the top of my gumboot. I'm in the top swale. I've got 400 meters of water. It's nice and wide, look. So, here's my swivel pipe. It's not quite going over the level sill spillway, so we're at saturation point. I may as well just let it down. Just swivel it, just a little skidding. There we go. Back down that way is the level sill. We're right at the tip top, early in the morning. Let the swivel pipe down. Can't be any wetter than this up here. And on it goes down to the next part of the system where I'm going to adjust another swivel pipe, and I'll show you that one too. Before I go down the hill, I just want to show you what I've done. I've just let that go. So it's going to go on down here, and then a little dam down there, a little key point dam called Owen's Pond. And just up from Owen's Pond, I'm going to walk up that swale before I get to plugging the hole. If plugging the hole's full, I'm letting that swivel pipe down over there, and I'll show you the action when I get there. Here I am coming down the laneway. I've got my surf vest on, thin neoprene and lycra arms. And I've got my, look at these, trendy. I've got my long surf shorts on and my short gummies, my soft sloggers. You just get wet anyway. Everything goes over your gumboots. Kookaburra's having a good laugh about it. You put a coat on in these tropical summer rains, and you get soaking wet with sweat, which is not so pleasant either. So you're gonna get wet, you may as well just get wet. So that's my deal. Here we go, plugging the holes full right up to the input pipe. I can see the swale input pipe here. It's still coming in. It's going over the spillway. It goes down here over this spillway. It's a conventional spillway on the other side of the dam. Beautiful dam, this one. Rob Avis was on the course when we put this one in, from Verge Permaculture. We built it in 2 days, and 2 days later it was full, but we drained it out this year. There we go, there's a bit of a scene across the Shannon Valley. And the next dam below, which is the second youngest dam on the site, that's full too, because plugging the hole goes over to a little dam there that backs up a swale under a crossing pipe and fills that one. So we're full. So the middle of the property is full. So I don't need all this water. She's saturated. I can let it go down to the lower systems. And in the next couple of days, or maybe even today, we'll be full right the way through the property. So I'll just hop over this electric fence, especially with my wet boots. I'm gonna have to be careful. Here's a little swivel pipe here. Sorry about the rough cut, guys, but it's... we're out on the field. There we go, I dropped that one down. I can hear it let go on the other side. There we go. That one goes down there. In amongst the vegetation, nice and secure. And it adds to that dam, which goes on down and adds to another dam, of course. But I'll kind of ask pull up now. We're going to have a look at the bottom of the system and maybe share some more details of how we handle a bit of a flood. Well, not really a flood, but plenty of water. So we're in the middle slopes, and I've just let another one go, another swivel pipe down to our lower swales. So very few dams are empty now. Here we are, swivel pipe on the ridge. This is at the end of our campsite there. So this goes out on a ridge line, all full, everything's saturated. I can drop it. Sound running. Oh yeah. That goes on down. There's a pipe crossing line going over here and goes on down to the next well. I think that one's full too. I'm going to be dropping a couple more. Coming down from up there. Another crossing pipe across the laneway. Swale over there is full. Swale over here is full. And it's going over the level sill at the end. You can see the water going over the level sill here. That means I can turn this swivel pipe down too. Raining through the water underneath the trees. Oh yeah. Still in the middle of the property. Walking through, I'm wading through to get to the next level sill. And we've definitely got some water now. I can see the star picket coming up. Swivel pipe. And drop that down a bit. There we go. It's just taking the top off it. It's charging over here. Let's go and look at the next one. The next one's full as well. This one's got two swivel pipes. You can see, I'm well above my gumboots now. Okay, and there's frogs. Frogs spawn everywhere. Frogs are having a real good time. So, up here, find the swivel pipes. I've marked them with a steel post. Until these swales are forested, which they should be a lot quicker than we're getting to it, but we're doing so many demonstrations so quick. You can see a steel post coming up. There's the pipe. Bit stiff. And I can drop it over there. Thanks to Mr. Sam Parker Davis for marking these for me earlier in the year. If he's watching this, I'm sure he's claiming credit. Young Sam over there saving the world without a budget. There we go. Raise that up a bit there. Get the vegetation out of the way. Beautiful. That's charging over the back now. Oh, there we are. Found it. There we go. Now that water's going into our new swale, which has never had water in before. It was built in the earthworks course last year. It's still got water now. Poor swales had to live through a drought, nothing but a drought. And here she goes. I just let those two swivels go, but she was already full. And it's just covered in weeds, but that's all right. That's plenty of biomass to grow a summer cover crop and nice food for us. So we've got, might get a little bit of erosion on the back, but nothing we can't deal with. And that off goes down to a little tiny pipe here that's on this crossing. This could be a swivel pipe, but I've actually left it empty here and no end on it. And that's going through over here. And that's going through to a lotus paddy, which could be a rice paddy. Right at the moment, it's full of ducks. So we've got some nice duck nutrient here. Good morning, girls. There they are. And over here, I have a swivel pipe inside our rice paddy, lotus paddy. Ooh, that's sucking my head. Ooh, yeah. There. There we go. There's some cosmic pattern for you, sucking down the hole. There you go. So that's a swivel too. I can drop that. So we've got this crazy set of events going on. If it isn't obvious that you're going to get life responses, I don't know what is all this. And that goes on down here towards our chinampas, which are going to really overload now. Pretty overgrown, but we'll soon graze that off. Down to our bottom dam, which is filling rapidly. And there you go. Hope you've enjoyed this little bit of a rough cut ramble through Zaytuna Farm in a semi-aquatic state. And I think we're back from the drought pretty well. And I'll catch you guys later.